What's happening, guys? Rocks Original here. So sit back for the next 10 to 15 minutes and let me take you through the making of this epic Star Wars table.
I hope you know what you're doing.
So I had the perfect slab for this, sported horse chestnut. It was over 6 foot long, 3 inches thick, loads of character, and these look really nice with the epoxy. So yeah, let's get it through the thicknesser. I think this fan of Star Wars table. These are like, these are the asteroids.
Back offers us new galaxies to explore.
That one looks alright. The fake explosion and that. Come along, that one's not too bad. I've got to make like a thing around it and flames and that. There's a fire jet. So these two are going to be doing war. With lasers coming like lasers from there. Nice and dry and that. Right, so I just roughed up that Millennium Falcon. So remember that, put the smoke at the back of that as it's coming down like it's gonna crash. So I managed to get that in. I've got the Falcon now. I ain't put the lasers in yet, so I need to pour a little bit more epoxy. Shot a laser, it's gonna go through that brick, took him out, and then he crashes into there. Problem is, I've got to wait for it to dry, huh? Yeah. A look. Well, I just poured some clear over that just to see if it was going to run. I did dry it, I force dried it with the blowtorch, just grazing it just to speed it up. So it's not running, which is good. So now I know that I can pour. This is humongous, that, isn't it? Yeah, that looks good to me. So the best time to pour epoxy is when it is at the B stage, and that is when it is tacky to the touch. That will ensure 100% proper contact and ensure a proper bond.
Let's get this cover on it. That's it.
I straightened it up so it's all level and square. So yeah, that's it. Not on these. So after, what you do, just get the sander 180. You just round, get rid of that line so it's nice and smooth round over. So that's why you do it. A lot of people do it. There's different profiles you can do. There's all different router bits with different profile edges and stuff like that. Do all sorts of routers. I love the router. Very good tool.
Some more on this side from the middle, because the middle's already raised up.
Just go over it again. Sand it with a 240 or 320 and just get it all smoothed out. Don't go too much because you might go through the epoxy. Just get it like relatively flat. Wipe it and then sand it again. I've still got that little bit from that slit there, but that'll be gone on the next pour. As it goes, let me just get it. Now look at it now, that's just a little dot. But you need to get rid of that. Go along the whole lot. You don't want one bit level. You don't want one bit up and one bit down. But look at it, it's gone. So I'm going to start at 240 and work my way up through the grits to 3000 with a sander. Then we're going to use the 3M Fast Cut Extreme. And then after that, we're going to use the Meguiar's Ultimate Polish. And then we're going to polish it up with the wool buffing pad. Starting at 240, work my way up through the grits, 324, 6, 8000, 2000 and 3000 grits. Right, so this fourth pass, that's that soft wet pad. And wet this and all, give it a few squats. Time for the polishing. No, I've got to flip it over and get rid of the drip marks. Let's crack one. That little tiny bit there, look, it's not filled in, but I ain't gonna bother with that. That's character. I'll just drill the holes for the inserts and put a little countersink on the end of it. Yeah, so when doing your inserts for spalted wood, just put a little bit of this in it before you screw the inserts in with the glue also. Like do the glue like after. So you put a bit of this in the holes, or a little, one in a little bottle. And yeah, just give it 10 minutes and then go for the inserts. Strip it in there. And that's it, just repeat the process on all of them. Right, so I'm gonna use some of this contact adhesive. Just do like four at a time. There you go, Bosch, Bosch. Boom, Bala. So I'm gonna flip this over. What's that there? Oh, that was slightly raised, hold on. That's it. Yep, now we're being a Bala, boom, boom, Bosch, whatever I said, done. I hope it comes out all right. I put so much effort and work into this, took me ages to do. Yeah, let's get cracking. Oh no. Let me sort the... That's it. Oh, yeah. Right. Hold on. Hold on.
It's a trap!